times I'll be driving in my car or doing dishes, and I'll get a thought in my mind about a topic that I think would make an awesome video. And so I was looking in my phone, and I remembered I had written down this topic, and it was like a month ago, and I just pulled it up today and thought, okay, I'm going to make a video on that so I don't forget. And I'm going to keep this really short. I think too often we're too critical of ourselves. And sometimes if you go around or you notice people, you know people, that go around being critical of others, how they look, how they talk, the choices they make, the things that they do. You know, I would never do that with my kids. I'd never eat that kind of food, or I'd never let my child say those things or go to school looking like that. Or I'd never be caught out in public wearing that. Whatever it is, right? I think too often we watch other people on social media, we see their pictures or videos, we notice people in our communities, in our family, in our neighborhoods, and we're quick to be critical. And so I just thought I'd put it out there to try to catch yourself. Start paying attention to when you notice somebody, maybe for the first time, it's a stranger or somebody you see out on their front lawn. And as you drive past and you wave, notice the first thought that comes into your mind. Is it a critical thought? Like, oh, they never waved to me. Why are they waving to me now? You know, it must be a fake wave. Or, you know, or look at their lawn. Oh, why don't they water it or get rid of those weeds? Notice the thoughts that are coming into your mind. Or are they positive thoughts? Like, oh, it's so good to see my neighbor. I never see them. Or, wow, she's lost a lot of weight. Whatever it is. Whatever it is, start paying attention to the thoughts that first pop into your mind when you think about someone or when you see someone. That'll tell you right there. It's kind of like a mirror, like a gauge of how we see ourselves. So if you are a critical person of yourself, so if you are very critical of yourself, chances are you're thinking critical about other people. And oftentimes when there's something we don't like about somebody else, it's because they remind us of something we don't like about ourselves. So maybe we have, you know, maybe it's somebody who's the extreme opposite of us, and everything we're bad at, it's their strength, and they're so good at it. So every time we see them, we're reminded of all the things we're bad at. And so start paying attention to, if you are a critical person, why you're being critical of others. Is it because there's things that you don't like about yourself? And if that's the case, fix it. It's so easy to start changing the way that you think. And they say you can't teach an old dog new tricks, but I tell you, if you just start catching yourself in those thoughts right when they happen and change them, it'll become a habit. So start paying attention to what you're thinking and make sure you focus on the positive in everyone. As you start focusing on the positive about others around you, then you're slowly going to start seeing positive in yourself, and you're not going to be so critical about who you are. Now, the reason I want to talk about this is because I feel like right now the adversary works so hard at getting us to hate ourselves, to hate everything about us, to feel like we're not good enough, we're not worthy, we're not talented, we're not smart enough, we're not capable enough. And, you know, there's so many other people out there who can do it better than us. Whatever it is, it's not true. It's a complete lie. And all of us have a light within us. And we can choose to shine that light bright and blind others, you know, to show that light, to show that truth, to show that goodness, and lead others to that light and to that goodness. We can be an example. We can be a lighthouse. Or we can dim our light, cover ourselves up, hide our faces, and choose not to be seen. But I think it's a little bit selfish. Sometimes people think it's selfish to be out there in the spotlight. You're just thinking about yourself. I think it's actually selfish to hide yourself from the light, to disguise yourself, to hide your face, because we all have something good we contribute to this world. We all have a reason we're here. We all have a purpose. And when we hide ourselves and we hide in the shadows and we're ashamed and embarrassed to show our face or to be seen, we're dimming that light. And think about all the people out there who aren't being influenced by you, who aren't being influenced by your goodness. And everybody has goodness. Everybody has something to bring to the table. Everybody has something to offer. So don't for a minute think that you don't, because you do. And we're all different. We all offer different things. And so I just think it's important, because I think the adversary is heavily attacking us on this right now. And I bring this up because I recently attended a funeral where the woman who had passed away had gone her whole life hiding her face and hiding in the shadows. And she hated people taking pictures of her, hated it, didn't like being on video, didn't like having her face anywhere, wasn't on social media, right? She just didn't like anyone seeing her face. And she was a critical person. She was a nice lady. She had a lot of great qualities about her, but she was very judgmental and critical of others who were different than her or that she didn't understand. And so I see that always happening, that when you are critical of others and you judge others, you're very quick to judge yourself. You're your own worst critic. You're sometimes your worst critic. And it was really sad because at her funeral, her kids talked about that and said that it was really hard to find pictures to show at the funeral and to display, and that they realized they don't have very many physical memories to show their kids, to show her grandkids and future generations, because she didn't leave anything behind. She didn't keep a journal. She didn't take pictures of herself. She was always quick to be out of pictures. I look back at a lot of our photos from parties she was at and events that she was at, and she's not in any of those photos because that's how she was. Now, she's not the only one. I know lots of other people who like to stand behind the camera but don't like to be on the camera. And even filming my vlog episodes, I always ask permission for people. I'll let them know, hey, I'm doing this vlog. I'm going to be getting my camera out. Are you okay with that? Do you want to be on film? Do you not? And for the most part, people are pretty awesome about it and they don't mind. But every now and then, I'll get people who say, no, I do not want to be on camera. I do not want to be on camera, which is totally fine. But it's just kind of sad that people are afraid to be seen. They're afraid to shine that light. They're afraid that someone might judge them or they might not look good. Or I know people who take pictures. Or somebody takes a picture with them on their phone and they have to hurry and look at it and approve it. And if their belly doesn't look the right way, or the shadow isn't on their face right, or you can see things they don't like about their body, they'll have someone retake that photo a gazillion times until it's just how they like it. And that's the photo that they're gonna put on social media because that's what they want people to see. And you know, for me, that's a hard way to live. I'm just okay with whatever comes up. I mean, you've seen my videos. I have videos where I have no makeup on. It's early in the morning. My hair's not even done. But that's reality. That's who I am. And I'm still gonna let my light shine. I don't care what people think. And I know for the most part, my light shines more powerful than the outer beauty. So if I'm having a day where my hair is not looking great or I don't have any makeup on, it's okay. If I have something positive to share from my heart, I'm gonna get on social media and share it. I'm gonna make a blog video about it. It's not about what's on the outside. I don't care what people are thinking about me, and most of the time I'm not worried what they're thinking about me or even thinking that they might be thinking something about me. I'm focusing on what I can give them. Not what they're doing for me, but what I can do for them. So it's not selfish, it's like a service. It's what are you giving? What are you putting out there? What are you contributing to the world? And when you're worried about yourself and what people are going to think about you and if you're going to look right, sound right, talk right, and you're critical of your voice and your image and your appearance and your behaviors and actions and you're easily embarrassed by your own self, you know, it's just a sad way to live. And so I just want to put it out there. Don't let the adversary win. Don't let him control you. Get him out of your mind. Get him out of your life. Get him out of your thoughts. Get him out of your heart. Get him out of you. He has no place in your life. He has no place to tell you that you're not good enough and that people don't like you or you're not beautiful enough or you're not talented or creative enough or the things you say are silly, ridiculous, embarrassing, don't make sense, you'll make a fool of yourself, right? Who cares? He's wrong and he knows it. He's a liar. And the truth is you're amazing. You're amazing. You're filled with light. You are divine. You have something powerful to contribute. And if you could just take away your body and see what's on the inside, see your spirit and how bright it shines and how glorious it is, that glory would be blinding. I mean, you would be surprised at your own glory. I know that's true. And so forget about your outer shell, forget about your body, and realize who you are on the inside, who you were before you came here, who you can become, the potential that you have going forward, who you can become. I mean, it's just exciting. It's amazing. And we should all feel comfortable in our own skin. And so that's my message today, is just don't hide your light. Don't hide under a bushel. Shine your light. Shine your light as often as you can. Don't be afraid to let people see your face, to let them see your light, your smile, your eyes, all of it. There's always going to be somebody out there that you're going to influence for the good. Someone can always benefit from what you have to contribute. So even if it's just one person or it's 30,000 people, it doesn't matter, because every person that you influence and that benefits from you and your light, they're gonna go forth and shine that light. The light that you give them, they'll take from you, they'll shine it on others, and it's like a domino effect. And so it's awesome. I remember once being at my in-laws, and I was so excited because we don't see them very often. I had my camera, I was taking pictures, and every time I would go to take a picture, I think this was when I first kind of met them. Every time I would take a picture, everybody would do this, or hold a book in front of their face, or this, and every photo I had, it would just be a furniture or of a tree, and you would see people, but they would be doing this. It was every single time, and I almost had to be sneaky just to get their picture. And I didn't understand why. I didn't understand why. I thought they were beautiful people. They are beautiful people. And I didn't understand why they were so embarrassed to have their face. Now, this was before social media, so I wasn't going to put their face out there on the internet. They just didn't want to be on camera. And, you know, that's totally fine. I respected their wishes, but I thought it was strange. And so now when I go back and look at, and I show my children those earlier years of our marriage, we hardly have any pictures of them because there were so many photos of them doing this and this. And this was back when you had to develop film. So I could only take so many pictures. And it's kind of sad. It's kind of sad. And I think they've come a long ways. Now, when we go over, they're more willing to be on camera. And I don't know. I hope I helped with that. I don't know. But I think by being an example of being fearless about being out there, being on camera, letting your light shine, letting people see who you are and knowing you exist and seeing what you have to contribute, it just gives them that confidence to do the same. It sets an awesome example, and it really is inspiring. So go out there, be yourself, and don't be afraid to shine your light.